Kiwis could be caught short by dwindling toilet paper supplies, and this time it's nothing to do with the pandemic. The Pulp and Paper Union is warning of a possible shortage as a result of industrial action at a kawerau mill. Yvonne Tahana explains.
It's Rowley's worst nightmare, but a union says this is in the cards in the near future.
If you remember back in the COVID, didn't take long for there to be a run on toilet paper.
That's because 140 kawerau mill workers have been locked out of the factory for 2 weeks. They want a pay rise in line with inflation, which is running hot at 7%. They've been offered 3 plus a cash bonus.
Our members over the last 60 years have fought to get us the wages where we are now. And if we just roll over now and say 3%'s it, it's a kick in the teeth to all those members, I believe.
Ah, kawerau. It's a toilet paper maker's paradise.
The union claims 70% of the country's toilet paper is made here. It's owned by global company Essity, which reported a half-yearly profit of more than $300 million. Essity hasn't responded to a One News request for comment. This economist says lockouts are strange at a time of low unemployment.
In the current market, I wouldn't argue that's a very successful strategy.
Official statistics last week revealed median wages were up 8.8%.
So we've seen courier drivers and post-haste, they've had a really good pay rise, 11%. We saw Pack and Save Upper Hutt, they had a pay rise of around 12%. Auckland Council in the public sector, they saw a pay rise of 5.9%.
Countdown says it doesn't have any concerns about a possible shortage and is working with suppliers. The union says relations aren't quite in the toilet yet. It hopes to get back to negotiations next week. Yvonne Tahana, One News.